We are about that. Hang on, before we do, what's the name of the language? Right, good as well. Well, welcome again to the General Purposes Committee, and welcome David, a new member of the committee. I don't think anybody else. Oh, sorry, he's our own member yet. You're on the 2000s, mate. Anyway, you're welcome as a I'm not sure you'll enjoy our committee. Right, no one wants to be filmed or because no objection, is there?
Yeah.
No? Okay, that's fine. Right, apologies. Thanks, David. And anyone else? No, quite sure. Okay, that would be good. Right, item one, anyone got any interest? The minutes of the last meeting. Can I agree?
Agree.
Okay.
If we were to bring in the requirement for
medicals to be every 3 years from the 1st of August, it would be dysfunctional with the 3-year licences starting in October, and it would make more sense to have that to coincide with when we issue a licence in October, then that licence will be for 3 years. Therefore, we would want that driver to have had a DBS check before we issue that renewal for 3 years. And that is the reason for the request to move the start date from the 1st of August to the 1st of October. As indicated, there is other information that I do need to update you on, and I do propose to run some briefings and training on the changes that the Deregulation Act has brought in ahead of the next meeting, because there are a number of changes I think that we need to look at as an authority to take into account that we will be changing our practices from issuing licences on an annual basis to 3 years. And we need to take into account that drivers, although it is conditions of their licence and there is policy there that they must update us in terms of their criminal records, etc., that we do know that this does not routinely happen. So we will need to put measures in place to ensure that we do protect the public in all ways, not only through the health of drivers, but in terms of us keeping informed of any driving offences or any other offences that drivers may commit whilst they hold a licence. So I will be seeking to update you in terms of the legislation, and then we'll be bringing some policy changes to you for your comments and approval or otherwise in terms of how we move forward with the changes in the legislation.
Thanks, Margaret. And just to say that, before, because there's a couple of questions that people have indicated, I'll be honest with you, a couple of taxi drivers, about one of the medical chambers, and I said that it's been well thought out. It's been to the Joint Consultative Committee, which Steve chaired, and Steve reported back to say there was no big thing about it, and I asked Steve to comment on that. So, I made sure the license office and they assured me that a letter was sent to every single taxi driver and every business. So, you know what's like sometimes? If you've got the letters, you can say the items that we have.
Well, on taxi drivers,
I think it's disgraceful. Yeah. So, I'll run the minute. Steve, would you like to know, unless Mark is one of them, just to comment for the rest of the members of the committee, what the thoughts were at that meeting?
The representatives of the taxi trade were quite happy with the union manager. They didn't seem to be overly fussed, because obviously it could have been an annual manager, but it could have been. Well, as I said, even into the 2 years, they were quite happy with it.
Okay.
Yes, just to assist members, if you are getting inquiries with regard to the medicals, and you may get reference to the DVLA sort of long distance drivers, they have to do it. And we presented that model in terms of, they do it every 5 years from 45 onwards. It's important to note that in terms of those licences, it's because that's when those licences expire. So in order to get a licence after 5 years, you need medical, which in effect is the same model that we will be adopting, because people will need to renew their licence on a 3-year basis. In order to renew it on a 3-year basis, they will need to do a medical. So it's linking in the length of the licence with the requirements for the medical. I mean, we have already been speaking to drivers, and Margaret had first-hand experience of this, where once they know that they're from October, whenever their licence is due for renewal after that date, they will be issued with a 3-year licence, they're actually coming forward and saying, oh, I suppose I'll be expected to do a TBS check and a medical at that time. Is that correct?
Yes.
And so I think the changes in the legislation support the movement towards, certainly medical of 3 years, and I say the expectation of drivers that, they probably, just thinking, well, I'm going to get this license now for 3 years. And I say there's quite a number of things we'll need to have in place before October in order to make that transition as smooth as possible and also ensure that we protect the public.
Councillor, you said that it would be 3 years and that's the version. It would just be the normal procedure that you've got to have, and the evidence is given of what they've done and what the procedure has done. And I mean, if you choose before one, you should have his own master. So, what do you mean?
I'd expect it to be on that basis. What we haven't had as yet is what the guidance is in relation to exceptional circumstances. And once we've got that, then we'll work towards that. And yes, we'd then bring a report to this committee to see if we wanted to delegate that to the licensing panel to deal with those particular applicants.
So just finish up. Yeah. How do you gather the information? How do you gather the information? If there is someone under their power or bring it to us, or please make it tell us all those sorts of circumstances.
Yeah, I say that there's been no central guidance at the moment as to what those exceptional circumstances would be. And I think as we probably get nearer to October, we should hear what those circumstances would be. And also then we start to get case law which determines it. But yes, I mean, you will still get, obviously we still have in place our convictions policy. So you will still get, for any new applicants and any existing drivers, that process will still be in place, whereby if there is doubt as to whether or not they are a fit and proper person, they will be brought before the licensing panel.
That's why I made the comment at the 2003 committee, there is going to be some legislation that affects this committee, and we may have to deal with it sooner than later. We'll come back to it.
We're doing a lot of training. We get some briefings like we go to October with an update on the time. What do you think so?
Yes, thank you, Chair. I mean, what I want to do is to organise specific training to update you now on what the legislation is. And then, yes, certainly we'll look at doing.
As up to October, things will be changing all the time.
Well, it could
so
be.
Give us an update on
the time. But we certainly need to organise some training sooner rather than later. I mean, it won't take that long, but it will be just an update on what the Deregulation Act has done and whether or not we do that ahead of the next meeting of this committee. I have spoken to the Chair and asked the Chair, we do need to have a further meeting of this committee ahead of the scheduled meeting September. We will need to have a meeting before we break for the summer holidays, really.
Okay, then.
I've
got John in front of you, Chair.
I didn't
know
he was here. Mark, you just say that you're going to write to all the taxi drivers to let them know, are you going to let them know about the change of the dates? Also, when you do so, would it be possible to ensure that we highlight that you must tell us any change of addresses, because we always get that, any convictions or pending convictions, because they come up 6 months later and go, I didn't know. But also, can we just tell them to please read the licensing conditions that they've got before them? And we will not have this come towards the committee saying, sorry, I didn't know.
Just to add on to that, what we are also going to be doing is writing to all the medical centres as well, to alert them of the fact that they could get an increased demand for medicals from October. So we will be letting them know so they understand, and also directing them as to where they get the Group 2 medical standards. They should have them, but the reference point for those standards as well. So we will do that. Everything was pending this particular meeting, So if you agree the recommendation to move the start date from 1st of August to 1st of October, we will get an information letter out to all drivers and let them know.
So can I just deal with that?
I'll do that.
You do that and second that. So that's been agreed. Okay, Councillor.
Yeah, I just wanted to check, was there any significance in that 1st of August date? Wasn't it an arbitrary 4 months after our decision?
Yes. I think it was to give drivers sufficient time to prepare, and had the legislation not changed when it did, we'd have already got that information out to them, but we've held on to it till tonight's meeting.
Do you know what I always say? It has been that, not been. But the panel says to be told what we're looking for with taxi drivers, things to look for.
Yeah. But there's the. What was also approved on the committee was the Group 2 medical standards. It's quite a comprehensive document that they check against, and if they've got any doubt, then there's certain things there that they should notify the DVLA of as well, but that they would not pass that individual. So it's the same standards of those who are driving HGV vehicles.
There's a couple of things I want to share with you. Those people sell the taxi cab, marketing, the job centres are being sent in people to the panel. But they have not been, we don't think they've been shown them in the terms of reference that we have, the policy. So someone comes thinking they're going to get a taxi job. They haven't read the terms and conditions, they haven't read our policy, and some of them. We would have to go outside the policy. So, Margaret's sent letters on two occasions, haven't you,
We did rely on Mersey Glen did contact the Job Centre on our behalf because they were liaising with regarding the training of drivers, so they covered it in that respect. However, I was informed over today that we had several applicants that didn't turn up for appointments recently for new applications. And I'm reliably informed by Margaret that they were applicants who had been referred by the Job Centre, but when they went, it could be that when they got back to the Job Centre, they were not aware of the fee change. If you remember, there was a change to the fees that was agreed from £10 to £55, and they've not gone ahead then with those applications. Really just re-emphasising that. and making sure that we as an authority have proper procedures and policies in place that enforce that, and make sure that anybody who is applying for a licence goes through the appropriate checks. And we, as I say, we have those policies, we have the convictions policy, we will be reviewing that this year, so that's one of the items of business that will come to this committee for you to refresh and review and have a look at. And as I say, it's important that as members, when you are considering applications, that foremost of your mind is about protection of the public.
On a serious note, there's only you. If you went on this committee, you wouldn't know yourself. That means well, I haven't done it, but, you know.
Yeah. Can I come in before he does come in?
Can I just say, I've never thought of my role as examining a vehicle and seeing whether it's roadworthy or not. I don't believe that's my role.
Can I just say, can I just come in on that?
It's the general appearance, isn't it? It's the condition of the car. And whether we think it's a suitable vehicle to be transported by Mr. Buckley. If I thought it was anything to do with examining the engine or anything like that, I'd not task
it. It's whether the body weight's safe and things like that, which it is. It's only you that knows it, isn't it?
Yeah. Can I just say, when I do it, I express an opinion, and it's up to yourselves whether you take that opinion on board or you just ignore it. It's my personal opinion at the time, and sometimes I can be wrong, but I can assure you, no. Many, many years of experience. I've had something like 50 years of experience.
Should be not to go. Even that's what it might be able to do.
Can you want to come in?
I was going to say, you know, yeah. Mm-hmm. You're not asking. Say it's about 10 years old, or whatever, renewed for 6 months. Yeah. Could not go to somewhere like Walsh's, who will say, roadworthy wise, it's fine.
That's that role that Councillor Sorrell said, that is the issue. As far as your duties as members, you're not there as engineers. You're there to look at the safety. I mean, if the vehicle had a missing handbrake and you had vehicles like that, then yes. you might want to say, hang on a minute, there's something missing here. And we've had examples of that in the past. But in relation to the comfort of the vehicle, the safety of the vehicle, the way that it's presented, those are the issues, you know, that you're looking at really. The issues about whether the engine is leaking or other matters are really issues that should be addressed by an independent, qualified mechanic. And I appreciate what John is saying, but in relation to that, when an application is brought before you, it does come with, it should come with a full MOT, which indicates that it has passed the MOT. So as far as the engine side, I mean, there may be different people have a different view of it, but as far as you're aware, then you have to take that on board and not hide behind it or go behind it. The issue you've got to look at is safety and comfort and anything that is obvious that may cause you to
disagree. Yeah, you said you're aware that fire engines, electric onto the road, and people with the flags, all those sorts of things. So, yeah.
Okay. And the last thing I did have another point to share with you all is that those people that's on the taxi pan, I spoke to Marge about this, we have been busy on the phone, Marge, is that members, I think that we shouldn't wait till we have 14 drivers' applications. I don't know what the rest of the members think, it's on the taxi pan, but I would rather come in another day and get half a dozen cars or have them and come in and get them done. So I wanted to share that with you. Okay then, so we agreed on recommendations.
Three.
Yeah, I mean, to go back to item 3, as a matter of record, we should just want to read the terms of reference set out in the right of the finance ministry. Is that agreed?
They need to be. The names of the deputies, if they haven't been provided, they should be provided.
We'll provide them tomorrow. So that's that. So, Andrew, is your business?
Just stop me.
if you pick up my savings at the wrong time.
Yes.
You know, I know it's all about the contract for the taxis with the council.
Yeah.
And there's problems with the service and the contract because of the company drives the place. Is that the answer? I should not discuss that.
No, I wouldn't have that.
That's
not
the answer. That's the meeting.
What I have done, by the way, again with Margaret, is that people, and this is public knowledge, it's not enough, but people are being complaining, several complaints I've had, that you can't get a taxi back from you, right?
Yes.
Now that's the Jew and the crown in the middle. Exactly. I know his postman, he was meant until for a night out, it's going to be a bad one. Andrew says that you can't get a taxi.
Well, is it a council function? I
couldn't get back. I couldn't get back. No, I couldn't get back.
Taxi.
Well, Margaret, do you want to
because we've stopped it.
No, that's fine. So, we're looking at that. We're looking at the. I think there's a new man calling.
You know what I'm saying.
Okay.
So,
I'm
just interested. Do they stop at a certain time?
Yes. Yes.
Surely that's up to them.
Yeah.
On to the
old space, yeah. It's explained. Yeah. So, we've agreed all recommendations. And there's nothing else, Margaret. No.
Just the training.
As
was referred to earlier, and in the other committee, because I've obviously trained there, members expressed a preference of timing around about 5:30. Would that suit members of this committee? If I was to look at dates.
I should also get a very.
Yeah.
Sorry. Well, yeah, I mean, it can be earlier. I mean, I'll do anything to suit members, really.
Well, that's
You might have to
do two training sessions on the same subject, depending on the idea.
Would it help if we were to look at, say, the next committee? If it was just half an hour, because it will only be about half an hour, honest, on this one. If we just did half an hour training before the start of the next committee, that makes more sense. Yes.
Well, just to say, before the end of the meeting, thanks for attending. We may have to deal with some business on taxis registration sooner than later. Okay. Well, thank you for attending.